Unions have stormed a cargo ship docked in Sydney, claiming its Russian crew is being exploited. Foreign ships dominate our coastal trade, but their workers are paid a pittance, and they're taking local jobs. TEN's John Hill has this exclusive report.
The Doris is a bulk carrier operating under a Maltese flag. Work unloading a cargo of gypsum from South Australia was halted when officials from the International Transport Workers Federation went aboard to confront the captain over wages. Crew members are paid just $250 a week.
It is owned by a Russian-based company in Vladivostok called DD Shipping, and the reason that they flag it out to Malta is to get away from taxation regime, to get away from any regime that enforces any regulation on board this vessel.
The ship has been operating in the eastern Australian states for 5 months. The union says the crew of 19 are Russians who face being put off the ship if they complain.
Paying $250 a week in wages to your seamen.
That's not Australian conditions.
I understood, but I live in Russia.
Unions are demanding the shipping company pay international minimum wages of $400 a week.
I'm sorry, but it's better for our country, better for us. Because in Australia, this is all very high, this, and this price very high, and this wage same very high.
They're competing against road and rail, they're competing against legitimate operators that pay tax, fringe benefit tax, that meet all of the requirements.
It was the deregulation of shipping under the Howard government that allows vessels like this to operate around the Australian coastline, employing foreign crews under third world wages and conditions.
This is an outrageous position, and that's why the Parliament needs to pass the Maritime Labour Convention.
John Hill, 10 News.